Spurs making it, the Spurs and the Kings making it, the last two spots. I just think the Clippers going to fizzle out there. And the Lakers is just going to just buy exactly. And then Minnesota is just Karl-Anthony Towns from nobody else. I mean, Karl-Anthony Towns in the overtime game, I think he dropped like around 35, 40-some points, and he was like, the next guy behind was like with 15 points. I don't know what happened to Andrew Wiggins. He just fell off. But yeah, it's just it's.
I think
it's,
Andrew don't want to be there.
But it's just this man carrying his team. I mean, Derrick Rose has probably been their second best player at sometimes.
which you're like, Derrick Rose has had a good year.
Yeah, well, yeah.
All things considered, been doing stuff. He's had a real good year.
Yeah, it's nothing against Derrick Rose. It's just you in a town with Karl-Anthony Towns and Andrew Wiggins, Jeff Teague.
One's supposed to say Derrick Rose is the next best player.
Exactly. You got some talent in this team, and you shouldn't. Yeah. So I don't know why this team is losing this bad here. I guess they just kind of sell for the one playoff berth that they got last year. And that.
After all that Jimmy Butler stuff and everything, it just – it set them back, and they just never recovered from it.
Yeah, makes sense.
That's what happens when you have something like that go on. It just distracts you too much, and people don't want to carry on after that.
Yep. In the East, you got Detroit Pistons, 7, Charlotte Hornets at 8, Orlando Magic 9, and Miami Heat at 10.
Oh, look at you get that little boost in your voice when you're like, Magic
in playoff time. What do you think about the East playoffs here? Because you got Brooklyn, who's 32-32, and their schedule is tough coming up. A lot of people think they can slide out.
They probably can. It just depends on who gets hot at the right time.
So
and how everything goes. Orlando's arguably playing better than anybody that's down there.
Yeah.
They're probably playing the best ball out of all of them, besides Brooklyn. But they've definitely been impressive over the last little bit. Miami can't figure themselves out. One day they want to be real good, the other day they want to be crappy. Or they're a team from half to half. One half they want to be excellent and go up by 20 points. The next half they're like, screw it, we don't want to play anymore.
So check this out, Brooklyn. They got y'all tonight, the Heat. And but in March they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 games on the road, and it's including the Thunder, Jazz, Clippers, Kings, Lakers, Portland Trail
Blazers. Oh yeah, they got a brutal
76.
They got brutal schedule coming up.
Yeah, so that's why I said they could slide out.
but Orlando has been playing well. Orlando's probably playing the best ball out of everybody in that lower section right now.
On the flip side, Orlando's got an easy schedule to close the season. They've got the third easiest schedule to close the season. So the thing about Orlando, they're winning games that they shouldn't, and they're losing games that they shouldn't. Like, how in the world do you beat?
You lost to the Bulls.
You lost to the Bulls and the Knicks, and then you turn around and
beat beat the Golden State Warriors.
You beat the Warriors and the Raptors.
Yeah.
Orlando, listen, Orlando is one of the most confusing teams. Like someone put it on their podcast yesterday for Jalen Jacoby's show. Orlando is like the best worst team in the playoffs that's remaining because they're beating all these good teams, but they lose to all these teams that they have no business losing to.
Don't tell me nothing. I'm a Heat fan.
So you know.
They are clones of each other. They're like, oh, we're going to go and beat Golden State. And then we're going to lose to somebody. We're going to lose to Phoenix.
It's just a sign of a 500 ball club. It's what it is.
It's signs of teams with just enough talent to get you over the hump, but not enough talent to be consistent on a daily basis.
Right.
It's that the teams have talent. They just don't they don't have, I don't know whether it's mental or it's just youth or whatever it is, but they just don't have that mentality to bring that kind of thing every night. And I know it's a long and grueling schedule, but if you know you're in the midst of a playoff hunt, everything, you have to want it.
Exactly.
And it's like sometimes half of them don't even want to be there and play it.
So listen to this. This is Orlando's schedule coming up in the middle of March. The Grizzlies, the Wizards, the Cavs, the Hawks, the Pelicans, the Grizzlies, 76ers, and then Miami Heat. So like,
and you would lose to like five of them
for some odd reason. And then and these should be winnable games. Like that whole stretch right there should be winnable games.
You beat Philly, who you shouldn't beat.
Right.
But then you'll lose to like the Grizzlies once, and then somebody else.
For some odd reason.
That's the way it's been for both of our teams this year. They make you go, all right, yeah, and then you go, why?
Exactly. I think they make it. I do think Orlando do make the playoffs. I think Brooklyn slides out. So I got Detroit, Orlando, and Miami sneaking in there.
Probably with the Hornets falling out, too.
Yeah, the Hornets got a tough schedule ending, too. But I'm looking at Brooklyn's schedule, man, and it's rough. If they can pull out some of these wins.
Brooklyn got all the easiness out of the way early. That's why they got it up.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. They're on a two-game losing streak, and then, of course, they're going against the Heat, who's been hot and cold. They was playing a good game against the Rockets, and then James Harden
went off. They were beating the Rockets by 27 points.
And then,
with Harden scoring 25 in the first half, they were up by 20 points. I'm like, what the heck are y'all doing?
Yeah, I thought y'all had that game won, and then they just
fold. It's like the youth that they have and everything. It just fold. I would have gave up anything to be able to go back in time, trade for Jimmy Butler.
Just have him on the team.
I'd have gave anything to go back because he would have been perfect for having him right now.
Yeah, he fits whatever y'all trying to do, man. He's got a dog in him and whatnot. Yeah, he fits what y'all would do.
But dude, I watched the tail end of the Golden State game when we were up on Golden State by like 20-something.
Yeah, talk about
and
that.
Here comes Golden State pouring back, and then that freaking game winner. I was like, look at him.
I watched. I was like, what in the world? I said, how?
Dwayne comes down, drills the three to put it in a one-point game. And then as soon as Durant misses that first one, I was like, uh-oh, they're going to tie this game up. I was like, they got enough time to go down, tie it up, or do whatever, and take it into overtime. And then he goes to shoot the three. He gets blocked. I'm like, damn, there's the game. And then he shoves it. I'm like, did he get it off in time? And everybody's just freaking out. I'm like, this bitch and his cornrows.
I know. What's up with the cornrows now, man? He just like going.
Hey, midlife crisis. That's all I
can do. He's ready.
Here's a crazy stat. He is one block away from tying Michael Jordan with the most blocks ever by a guard.
Oh, wow.
Yep. So he has two blocks away from beating Michael Jordan as the most blocks ever by a guard.
You got a lot of time to do it.
No, got the rest of this year. Yeah. I think he'll probably get it.
Yeah, but I say, yeah, he should be able to get that. You need to get a poster with him on that, man. I there was like some photo shoots of him doing it on the stand. I was like, man, Kevin got to get a poster of this.
Well, LeBron did it before after hitting the game winner.
Mm-hmm.
There too, but that's not that's not your place jumping up on those. Nothing, LeBron. Get off the podium. That's his podium.
That's way, yeah.
Yeah.
Now they had took a photo, and I was like, "That's a nice photo." If I like the Heat, I'll just send that to Kevin. I think that'd be a nice little photo for him. I think you saw it.
Yeah, I saw it. Because he went running around, and jumped up on the thing.
He couldn't believe it. It was wild, man. So
except he's got cornrow. That's the only bad thing about that photo.
Well, listen, I know it was probably a great feeling to shout them bandwagon Warriors fans. So,
oh, well, you know it, and then y'all got to do it the next one.
They didn't have the trip to Sunshine State that they wanted to plan, huh? Hang out at the beach and then go to Disney World and 2-0. Nah, 0-2. I literally went to the Magic game and I saw a guy with his Warriors hat with the tag still on it.
So he could take it back after.
I kid you not, I was trying to take a picture and he cut off and went to the lower bowl. I was like, ah! I wanted to expose you.
The thing that got me about them was that Kerr had the audacity to be like, we're about to play two of the bottom of the East teams. Let me go ahead and rest people.
Yeah.
Not giving the two teams that he was about to play the credit that they deserve.
Mm-hmm.
So he was like, let me go ahead and rest people. Well, that cost him.
Yeah.
Because he rested Steph against us and KD against y'all.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, well, have fun with that.
Yep. That's why I say, yep, we'll take it. And I'm sitting there watching and being.
Yeah, like we're talking about poor them. They still were able to send out five All-Stars in the starting lineup.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, because all they do is put Iguodala in and just move people around. So you're still putting in five All-Stars.
Their bench is bad, though. Their bench,
get out of here.
You didn't realize it, but their bench is really bad. I really don't watch many Golden State games. I don't stay.
Well, the only guy they got coming off the bench is friggin' Iguodala.
Yeah. Like some of these guys, they had come off the bench, like McKinney and Bell, is like, ooh, they really got to stagger their lineups in the playoffs. I know they shorten their rotation and stuff like that. It really don't matter. They got all the All-Stars. But they're going to hit some dry spells like they did against the Heat in Orlando.
What they did was they messed up when they didn't let McGee back, when they didn't bring McGee back.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you got Cousins now and everything, but you still need somebody off the bench, especially when Cousins hasn't played a lot. Yeah. I know he's starting to get his win now, but he hasn't played a lot.
Yeah.
He fits in with him nicely. That was a sick pickup for him.
Oh, yeah. Nah. And he's playing good ball. I know he went cold at the end of the game playing against the Magic, but yeah, he's playing great ball. So
he just gets tired. He still hasn't got fully invested back into the season yet. But by the end of it, he should be full go for the playoffs.
Oh yeah.
God, they're so damn good.
they are good, man. I'm sitting in amazement because that was my first time actually like watching Curry in a long time. And watch him operate. I know he missed a lot of shots, but the way that he's able to go get his shot and get the ball and cut around screen.
The way he gets himself open.
Yeah. But I will say this, there's a lot of illegal screens too.
Oh God, yeah. Half the stuff the rule book in the NBA has been basically cut in half. Or they just tell the refs, look here, you need to let stuff go because we want the game to be more entertaining. So you need to just let stuff go.
Yeah, they're dust on the books. It's time.
Let them play, yeah.
All right. So let's keep moving. I know we'll the closer we get, we'll talk more about these playoffs because it is interesting because, our teams are involved in it. So James Harden, man, is his consecutive streak of 30 points per game has ended at 30, at 32 against the Hawks.
Did you see the end of the game?
Yes, where they all went up to him to make sure he didn't get up a shot.
Three people just surrounded him.
It's like, you're not going to get these points, bro. You're not going to get. And of course,
you're not getting two more points.
And then,
no.
And then, of course, your poor Heat had to watch him pour in 52-some points that night. So it's just like, okay, well, I guess he was wanting to start a new streak. But anyways.
This shows you how reliant they are upon him. If he wouldn't have done that against the Heat, they were going to get wore out.
Yeah.
But that's how reliant that team is upon him, is he's all they got. Chris Paul divvy some in every once in a while, but he's the only thing that team has.
So I guess with James, and that is, listen, he's a talented player. I just watching him playing, and it's just ISO ball. It's just It's not fun to me, man. I guess in a way it is impressive how he getting his points and stuff like that. He had a streak going where it was like